Hello and greetings from Iceland. I'm starting the update by the glacier-covered highland volcano, Hofsjökull, and what you see is a little over 900 square kilometers of ice, and under it we find a caldera, 80 square kilometers, and around 700 meters deep. And this is one of the mystery volcanoes. We don't know much about its history, and even less about its intentions. But we do, however, know that we just got a magnitude 2.9 earthquake there. And I shot this time-lapse in the summer of 2023 after a short seismic swarm around there. And I do actually want to make a longer video from this glacier someday. But first, I need more footage and more information. And the volcano tour of the day will mostly be about the Reykjanes Peninsula. Like many of you might have noticed, the crater that has grown to be quite big now got filled up with lava 2 days ago, and we got a beautiful scenario for a while. And this turned out to be good news, since the lava had been flowing south until then, and also piling up south of the crater. And after this change, the lava started to flow to the north, where we have very good storage that will last us for a long time. And not only did the eruption power up suddenly, the land uplift took off again, so magma is accumulating in the Svartsengi magma sill once again, but at a slower rate than before, since the crater is still open for business. And I think it's too early to say if we are in for yet another inflation episode, or one of these episodes that will end up with something new every time. And furthermore, the inflation seems to be moving closer to the Eldvörp craters, which made me think about what two of our professors have been saying all along. Or those craters by the Eldvörp crater row, they will play a part in this chapter, although they haven't presented us with any evidence. So to make this simple, it looks as the eruption is not coming to an end. The Met Office was saying today that the eruption itself is slowing down, or when we look at the output from the crater alone. But when we add the land uplift into the equation, this has been extremely steady since January, or the inflow from a lower magma reservoir. But we prefer, of course, to let this just go on like it does now. And let's move to a few tourist issues. Our tourism industry has been bleeding a bit recently. And as always, it's the airlines that get the bad news first, then the hotels and the car rentals, and then all the way down to the hot dog stands. And the reason for this decrease in bookings can, for some part, be blamed on a huge amount of disinformation about the situation here in Iceland. Like, we have a tiny little spot there on the Reykjanes Peninsula, and the peninsula itself is a very little part of my country. And it is, of course, frustrating when tourists are cancelling for reason like AI photos showing everything going down the drain. And this has been getting so bad that the Icelandic media has been picking this up. There is pressure to have this stopped. And I'm linking to an Icelandic YouTuber that has covered this very well, or the most extreme samples. Since we also have to bear in mind that this is in many cases ruining travel plans. So this is not just about us, although we Icelanders have actually always been quite sensitive when it comes to how the world sees us, due to how isolated we used to be. And to explain that better, I'm linking to a video I made last year. It covers the story when the Icelandic ambassador in Washington applied pressure to the US government to make sure that Hollywood would change the name of a movie called Iceland due to all the fake information it contained. And strangely enough, they succeeded, and the movie Iceland became Katina. So that story for me, it was excellent material for a sarcastic video, and I had a great time doing it. So I recommend that you check it out. Because some of the feelings that we showed back then are still present.
I fell for one of those posters. It says, join the Marines and see the tropics. Ha! Look where I'm at, up here with the Eskimos.
And although we might have been a bit over the top sensitive back then, It is not about sensitivity when we watch the core of our tourism industry under attack because someone wants to make money even with the fake AI photos and thousands of jobs in the tourism industry. That is not sensitivity. And I can go on like this for a long time. The first three eruptions did actually do a lot for the tourism industry. And we remember how thankful our guests were to get the chance to sit by a nice little volcano, listen to it, feel the heat, and how the ground was rumbling or this out of this world experience for many. That made us think a bit deeper about the existence of Mother Earth. So we have been getting questions lately. When will we be able to see this volcano? And why is it still closed? The simple answer is, we don't have any people to guard the place, like we have always done. Like the search and rescue team in Grindavík. They took a lot of heat during the first three eruptions. But those people are now scattered around the country. That community is gone. And we also want to prevent that tourists go wandering into the town. And the overall mood has changed. This isn't the volcano mood that we had during the first three eruptions. And we know it now from experience that in order to do this right, we need a lot of manpower. So there is increased pressure to make this eruption site available to tourists. With staff that has gas detectors and provides emergency services. Just like we've done three times before with good results. The gas pollution is dropping. The lava flows to the right direction now. And things look overall better, although that could change fast. And before I finish on the Reykjanes Peninsula today, I want to mention that in my last full update, April 6th, I had unfortunately some technical problems with that video. And it was getting late and I was tired when I was rendering the video. So it slipped under my quality radar. And I'm sorry for that. And after I uploaded this video, the auto subtitles from the YouTube auto translation, they didn't appear. But I used them only as a suggestion before I make the necessary correction that I always have to make, which is a lot of extra work, but in return, the text will translate better into other languages. But most importantly, all Icelandic place names appear with correct Icelandic spelling, which can be very useful for those who want to look up those places I'm mentioning. I'm looking at the weather report now twice a day. I suspect that I might take off to Reykjavík in the next 2 days or so. It looks as I will be getting usable conditions soon. And I have 3 videos now waiting for the music license to clear. So I might have some landscape theme for you until my next update. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.